I wanted to make something out of myself. I wanted to do something great, you know? I wanted to do something out of the ordinary. My persistence paid off. Got associated with Obey Giant. You know, I started working there as an intern, getting like a $15 stipend check every day. And then I got put on hourly, and then I graduated with my associate's degree, and then I got put on full time. Being in that studio was one of like the greatest experiences I've had. You know, I mean, like, you're in an environment with pretty much a living legend. You know, like, just feeding off of his creative energy and his energy in general. And it was just great to be in an environment with like young, you know, tenacious people like in the game that I wanted to be in. This has made me so tired because it's not me. I'll come back for me. I decided to paint on the street to market the poster that I was releasing. Middle of the day, Saturday afternoon, hit up like four or five spots, and then everyone's just like, wow, who's doing these bears? You get really lucky one day, you know, everything goes on smoothly, but one time you'll get caught, you get fined, and or maybe even put in jail. You know, the streets giveth, the streets taketh away. I don't get pissed off if somebody disses my pieces or the buff man comes. I just know that, like, you know, that piece had its time. As long as somebody smiles. A spot I did recently on Mill Street, it got dissed, and I found out on the internet. My homie called me up and was like, dude, you gotta check this out. And I did, and it's a pretty funny diss. Like, I got no complaints. It's good, and it got the picture pretty viral on Digs and Twitter, I guess. Instead of, you know, completely fixing it, I'm gonna leave the diss, and I'm gonna paint another bear in who looks like he's getting caught dissing the other pieces. So, you know, I'm gonna let that guy's stuff ride because it's not too bad, and I think it's funny. And I'm just gonna put another bear in the middle of the two bears he dissed that has a spray can in his hand. The main reason I paint out during the day is because I look like I belong to where I'm at. So I like to, you know, walk up to the wall confidently like I own it or like I was commissioned to be there. Originally, I wouldn't bomb my own stuff, I'd, you know, help Shepherd out. We actually, we're in this little, like, town of London called Shepherd's Bush, and we're just putting up posters, whatever, and then all of a sudden I see a cop, you know, ca-caw, ca-caw. The police car pulls up to me, like, blocks my direction, and then they're like, excuse me, like, what are you doing here? I'm like, Shepherd, like, the other direction, came back to, like, basically save me and was like, oh, hey, what's up? Is there a problem here, officer? And like, oh, yeah, we're just, you know, campaigning for this movie that's coming out. Well, the running joke about the whole rest of the trip was like, yo, man, you do not want to get caught in Shepherd's Bush. Definitely have been getting up a lot in LA, but you know, I want to, you know, expand, you know, see what else is out there, what other spots I can hit. You know, I definitely like to go to London, Puerto Rico, you know, Russia, China, put up some panda bears in China, why not? Hopefully one day I can make enough money off of this art so I can pay for all that travel and get a whole new campaign out. Hard life is, how one little thing could like set you off, you can be angry for the whole day, and hopefully if they see a bear out on the street, they'll be like, oh, look at that cute little guy out there, you know? Maybe I don't want to punch an old lady in the face. You know, maybe I'd rather assist the old lady across the street. And that's all I really want to do. I want to change the world one smile at a time. Blue flame, splashing up your face, it's so sad.